Hello students, welcome to the 7th class on economic survey, and in this class I will be dealing with the 7th chapter of economic survey. Name of the chapter is clothes and shoes. Can India reclaim low skill manufacturing? So the title of the chapter is in the form of a question. It is asking a question. Is India having the potential to reclaim the low skill manufacturing? Now, as far as this chapter is concerned, I have divided it into three parts. In the first part, I will be dealing with the discussion about the low skill manufacturing versus high skill manufacturing. And in the second chapter, I will be doing the comparative analysis of India versus other countries. And in the last part of the lecture, I will be dealing with how India can meet the challenges. First of all, let us start from low skill versus high skill manufacturing. Now, as far as India is concerned, India never had the requisite technology. India never had the requisite skilled manforce in order to produce high skilled manufacturing products. Now, high skilled manufacturing products, they were already being produced after India's independence in the European countries and in United States of America. And China had mastered this high skilled manufacturing by way of reverse engineering the things. But as far as India is concerned, India predominantly was an agriculture country, and India has bypassed this manufacturing phase in its takeoff stage, and it has directly jumped to the service sector. So India has never focused on high skilled manufacturing products. But as far as the low skill manufacturing product is concerned, India had the requisite potential. But this potential was never utilized. This potential was never explored. And this is the reason why India has not performed well in specifically two subsectors of low skill manufacturing. Now, these two subsectors are the subsector of clothes, apparel industry, and the shoe industry. Now, how can we say that India has not realized its potential? Now, India has not realized its potential. We became aware of it when we have done the comparative analysis with different countries. We have done the comparative analysis with the East Asian countries, with the China, with Bangladesh, with the Vietnam, etc. Now, all these countries, they have registered a growth rate of about 20 to 30% in the apparel industry and in the shoe industry. But from India's perspective, if we take India's case into consideration, this growth was just 8%, 9%, 10%, and at the most 12%. And this is also the reason why India failed to address the demand of the Western countries. Why India failed to address the demand of United States of America particularly. And the share of the market which India could have captured, this share of market was overtaken by China. It was taken over by East Asian countries. And now India is lagging behind in both these sectors, clothes sector and shoe sector. Now, in order to analyze why India has lagged behind this, we need to analyze both these subsectors separately. First of all, we will be understanding about the clothes and the apparel sector. पहले क्लोथ एंड अप्रैल सेक्टर के बारे में जानेंगे. इंडिया ने इतना कम परफॉर्म क्यों किया है? तो एज फार एज द अप्रैल इंडस्ट्री इज कंसर्न्ड, इट इज नॉट अ यूनिफॉर्म इंडस्ट्री. It is not a homogeneous industry that you are just producing one type of clothes or one type of apparel. This is not the case. You produce multiple different type of products under cloth industry. You produce man-made fiber. You produce cotton clothes using machines, and then you produce silk, and there are different type of silk products. So this is the general categorization under the cloth industry. Now, as far as the world demand is concerned, duniya mein sabse zyada demand kiski hai? It's man-made fiber. Man-made fiber ka demand sabse zyada hai. But if we take into consideration India's case, in India we have put up more of taxes on man-made fiber. So the tariff is more on this man-made fiber. So this acts as a dissuadent. ये चीज़ है जो रोक लगा देती है इसका maximum potential explore करने में, जिसका demand दुनिया में बिल्कुल ही ज़्यादा कम है cotton का, cotton clothes का जिसका demand गिर रहा है, उसमें हमने कम tax लगाया हुआ है. So basically India is not supporting this man-made fiber. And this man-made fiber, that is the sub part of the cloth industry, is also important from the perspective of the employment that it can give to the people. The most of the cotton fiber that is produced, it is produced using machines, and its demand is also declining. And the increased automation in this cotton fiber has also led to the decline in the employment in the apparel industry. But India is not exploring this aspect. This aspect should also be explored, because clothing industry is one such industry that can provide maximum of employment to the women. And it will also help in doing social justice to the women section of the society. So from examination point of view, you must highlight this aspect of the cotton industry, this aspect of the cloth industry. So India really needs to capitalize on this. So we need to do away with the distinction of this aspect. Now, delving deep into this, we must also do the comparative analysis between the labor cost. Now, as far as India is concerned, the monthly labor that it gives to the workers who are in this apparel industry, it is around $110 per month. But this cost of labor in China has risen to about $250 per month. So there has been an increase in the cost of the labor in China, and the cost of the labor in India is relatively less. So India should have been a more favored destination. From China, the industry should have moved to India, but this is not the case. The entire cloth industry, it has moved to Vietnam and Bangladesh. So why it has moved there? It has moved there because these are the underdeveloped countries. And when they export their products to Western countries, no tariff is, no custom duty is applied on their apparel, on their products. And they gain comparative advantage vis-a-vis India's apparels that are produced. So what solution should India find in such a situation? In such a situation, India should do FTA, foreign trade agreements, free trade agreements with these countries like United States of America and European countries. Now, with the European Union, India has not been able to materialize its FTA, free trade agreement. And this is the reason that whenever we export these products, the import duty is imposed by the European Union countries, and it ranges from about 7 to 10%. Whereas from Vietnam and Bangladesh, No tariff, no taxes imposed, no import duty is imposed. So this gives a comparative advantage to those countries. So as far as growth is concerned, we have another problem in India, that is the problem of logistics. So what is this problem of logistics? In India, if you want a custom clearance, it takes about 6 days, 6+ days. But in China, it takes you only 1.5 days. So basically, trade is facilitated by China and trade is less facilitated by India. And the cost of moving the products per kilometer, it's high in India and it's very less in China. It's about half of what India charges to move a product for 1 kilometer. In China, it is less. So India really needs to work on this perspective of logistics. First of all, India needs to work on taxes, then it needs to work on logistics. And lastly, if India really wants to reclaim low manufacturing, skill manufacturing, India also needs to work on labor laws. That is very, very important. Indian labor laws, they are multiple in number. Rigmarole of labor laws exists in India. Myriads of laws exist in India. And these laws make it very complicated for somebody who is dealing in apparel industry or in shoe industry to operate. Now, if you are paying 15,000 to your labor class, he or she has to deposit a part of it to the employment provident fund. That creates a kind of a problem. So labor laws require tinkering in India, require a change in India. Because these labor laws, they put a lot of pressure on the corporate class. If you compare India's labor laws with the labor laws of China, in China has a very comparatively more flexible labor laws. But in India, that's not the case. If you want to shut down your business, first of all, you have to completely address the rigorous interests of the labor class. And this is what dissuades this sector from employing the people. This is the reason why there has been a lot of automation in the apparel and the shoe industry. So basically, India needs reform in these three parts. One is the taxes, then is the labor, and then is the logistics, TLL. So you must remember it like this, TLL. Then coming to shoe industry, you know, as far as the shoe industry is concerned, India imposes less taxes on the leather products. And leather is one of the input in the shoe industry. And world over, there is a decline in the demand of the leather shoes. People are giving up their desire to wear leather shoes. And there is a transition, there is a change towards sport shoes. They are more comfortable, they are more flexible. But India's domestic manufacturers producing sport shoes, they have to pay taxes in the range of 20-25%. And this is the reason that why Indian footwear industry is not competing well against that of China, against that of East Asian countries. So India, if it wants to have an advantage, it needs to tinker with this tax laws about leather industry. And then India also needs to explore the huge population of cattle that we have that remains less exploited. So From examination point of view, this chapter is very, very important. This chapter is important from labor laws perspective, or labor laws are hindering India's share in low-skill manufacturing, or tax laws should need to be tinkered. The last part of the lecture is how India can meet these challenges. These three challenges can be met if India will come out with GST, effective implementation of GST. Then we need labor law reforms. That is the must. Then we also need logistics. And how can this logistics mean? Samaan ko ek jagah se leke dusri jagah leke jana. Logistics mein improvement kaise aa sakta hai? Pehle to laws ko improve karna padega hame. जो ऑक्ट्राई ड्यूटी है, एक स्टेट से जब दूसरी स्टेट में जाते हैं तो ऑक्ट्राई ड्यूटी लगती है, उसमें आपने देखा होगा कि एक स्टेट से जब दूसरी बहुत सारे ट्रक्स की लाइंस लगी होती हैं, उसको हमें इंप्रूव करना पड़ेगा. सो वी नीड टू डी ब्यूरोक्रेटाइज द थिंग्स इन द लॉजिस्टिक सेक्टर, इन द लेबर सेक्टर एंड इन द टेक सेक्टर. दैट विल रियली गिव हेल्प इंडिया टू गेन इट्स स्पेस और रिक्लेम इट्स स्पेस इन लो स्किल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. हाई में तो अभी पॉसिबल नहीं है. Because India is investing, India had invested very less in R&D, research and development sector. Quaternary sector mein humne bahut kam develop kiya hai. Education sector is not to the level where we can explore and come out with patents and invest in manufacturing. That's a distant dream. The dream that is close to us, first of all, we must chase that dream. That is the dream of low-skill manufacturing. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you have any sort of query about this class. Now you can also install our application. Name of the application is BrainyIAS. You can find this application from Google Play Store and from App Store. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.